Hey, it's me, your favorite science teacher. I got bad news. I'm not here today. I know you're disappointed, but I'll be back on Monday. But what you're going to do today is I do have some work for you. We are going to do ACT practice.
Yay.
I know it's something that you like, but we're going to do that, and that'll help us get us ready for the ACT. Because when you take your ACT, your best section will be in science. All right. And so what I'm going to be giving you is this sheet that looks like this. Okay. And you're going to fill out this sheet while I go over it. Okay. And so you're going to fill this sheet while I go over it. And so that's what I want you to do. Okay. So it should be already passed out to you. And we'll start with that now. If it isn't, pause video. Right. Continuing on. All right. You can see that we're looking at cloud cover, and this is a charts and graphs passage right here. This is a charts and graphs passage. And I know it's charts and graphs because it doesn't say anything about experiment one or experiment two or study one, study two, or it doesn't say something like scientist A, scientist B. All right, and so when I see a charts and graphs passage, how much of the pack of the passage do I read? That's right. One to two sentences, probably just one sentence, because the whole story is going to be told by the graphs. All right. And so I'm going to read the first sentence. All right. It says, cloud cover is the percent of the Earth's surface covered by clouds. Okay. I want you to paraphrase what that said. Cloud cover is the surface, is the Earth's surface covered by clouds, or how much it is. All right, so you paraphrase that. Again, when you read your one sentence, it's not you have to comprehend your one sentence. You can't just say, oh, it's no big deal. You need to comprehend your sentences. So make sure you comprehend it. Right? And then the next thing is cloud cover may increase because of an increase in cosmic ray flux. All right. So it says cloud cover may increase with the cosmic ray flux. Okay. And the reason I read a second sentence, you say, well, why did you read a second sentence? Because the first sentence didn't tell me much. So I read a second sentence. Well, I don't know what cosmic ray flux is, so I'm gonna glance over what it says. It says the number of high energy particles from space reaching the Earth per meter squared per hour. And so it's the amount of high energy particles reaching the Earth per meter squared per hour. All right, so summarize and paraphrase those sentences over there. Paraphrase those sentences. It's the cloud again, so it's a cloud cover. Might be related to the cosmic ray flux. And then the second thing is the cosmic ray flux is the amount of energy that reaches the Earth per meter squared per hour. All right. All right. So continuing on. And again, the ACT is more of a reading comprehension test. So when I ask you to read something, you've got to comprehend. So that's why you have to do so well in this here. All right, next thing here is I see a table. When I see a table, I look at the which part? Yes, the headings of the columns and the rows. All right, and so these are my headings of the columns, cosmic ray flux, and cover of low clouds percentage. All right, and I looked at the headings of the columns. Now let's look at the headings of the rows. So the cosmic ray flux goes up. What does the trend here? As the cosmic ray flux goes up, so does the cover of low clouds. So it seems like there's a relationship. The trend is if you increase your cosmic ray flux, the cover of low clouds will also increase. All right. And again, we're doing this because I want to remind you that we're going to have a, you're going to do a passage right after this. So you need, this is, I'm teaching you how to look at passages the way I look at them here so that you can be successful at them. So that is your trend. As the cosmic ray flux goes up, the percentage of low clouds or the cover of low clouds also goes up. That percentage also goes up. Now I see a line graph. When I see a line graph, I automatically think, The independent variable is on which axis? The x-axis. And the dependent variable is on the which axis? Yes, the y-axis. And the independent variable is the factor that you, yes, change on purpose. And the dependent variable is the factor that you, yes, measure to get your answer. All right, and so the independent variable is on the x-axis, the dependent is on the y. All right, now, one other note is that line graphs can show multiple experiments. Like this one shows multiple experiments, all right? And they took did multiple experiments. They measured the average of clouds, all right? Of clouds, that's the dotted line. That's what they measured. That's on the dependent variable, and they measured every year. That's the thing that they changed on purpose. So every year in January, they measured the percentage of high clouds. And that's this dotted line, okay? But then they also measure the RCRF, which is the cosmic ray flux, all right? They measure that, and that is the solid line, okay? So in this experiment, they show two dependent variables. So the line graphs can show multiple dependent variables, and they also could show multiple independent variables. But in this situation, since there's two things written on the y-axis, that means they have multiple. Which variable? Dependent, yes. All right, so this has multiple dependent variables. So let's look at this first line graph. What's the independent variable in this first line graph again? It's the year, yes. The independent variable is the year. What's the dependent variable? This one is the monthly average cover of high clouds percentage, all right? But it's not just one dependent variable. They did two experiments. They show them in one graph. It's also the RCRF. That is also a dependent variable. And so that is also, because again, on the y-axis, they have two y-axes, and so they're showing both on here. Now, let's look at the trends. As the RCRF goes down and then goes up and then goes down and then goes up, what does the monthly average? Does it kind of go with it? Not really. So there's not really a strong correlation between the RCRF and the monthly average. So is there a trend? No. All right, let's look at the next one. Graph two, what did they change on purpose? The year. What did they measure to get their answer? The dependent variable, the monthly average of middle clouds percentage. And they also measured the RCRF. Again, remember, these line graphs can show multiple dependent variables if they're both on that here. And so this shows multiple dependent variables. All right, so is the middle clouds, they go up, they go kind of about stay the same, and they go down, up and down here. The RCRF goes down, up, down, up. They don't look like there's any correlation again. No correlation. So there's no correlation in figure two. All right, figure three. All right, figure three. You can see the independent variable is the year. The dependent variable is the monthly average of low clouds percentage. And then the RCRF is also the dependent variable. So they have two dependent variables. And when the monthly average of low clouds goes down, it goes up, and then it goes down, and it goes up. Well, the RCRF does the exact same thing. Okay, so is there a relationship with these? If it goes down, the other one goes down. If it goes up, the other one goes up. And so there's kind of a direct relationship with these here. You can see that with these here. And so that's what we're trying to show right here. So this is kind of this shows a direct proportional relationship. Now we're going to shift to the questions, all right? And then we're going to take our practice passage, okay? It says, the percent of the Earth's surface covered by high clouds in January 1987 was closest to which of the following? So I want you to paraphrase that question. I want you to paraphrase it on the side. And the reason I have you do that is because, again, if you can't paraphrase that, then you're probably going to get the question wrong. So paraphrase it. I'm going to let the video run for a sec. Okay, you were supposed to say again the percentage of the Earth's surface covered by high clouds. So what is the percentage of Earth's surface covered by high clouds? Okay, in 1987. So that's what we're trying to do. All right. So we have that here. All right. And so let's look and actually find the answer now. January 1987 by high clouds. Which one of these was high clouds? If you remember, it was this one. So 1987 and this 85, 86, 87. Which one is the cloud cover? It's the dot dash line. So I'm going to say about, what is that, 13.5%. So my answer would be B, 13.5%. Again, these questions are not as bad as you think. Now, you're going to be doing some in just a little bit. And again, you just, I want you to work through them like I've just told you how to. All right, the next one. I'm going to give you about 15 seconds or 20 seconds to paraphrase it, but I'm going to read it out loud to you. Based on table one, a cosmic ray flux of 440,000 particles per meter squared per hour would correspond to a cover of low clouds that is closest to which of the following? What I want you to do is I want you to paraphrase that question. Okay, all right, you should have said, all right, you should have said that as a cosmic ray flux if it has a cosmic ray flux of 440,000 particles, what percent of low cover would that be? Now look over here, let me paraphrase that. Again, this is a more of a reading comprehension test. If it has a cosmic ray flux of 440,000, what percent of low clouds? Okay. All right, so that's what we're looking for. So it said table one, too. So 440,000. Uh-oh, they don't go to 440. But I can find, this is the trend. This is what we did with that. If you remember with the bouncy balls, we can predict the data based on the rate of change that's already going on. So if it's 440, it's going up. If you look right here, the rate of change, every 20,000, it goes up by 0.3. All right, it seems like it goes up by 0.3. So I'm going to say about 29.3 would be my guess. All right, and 29.3 is there. So H is our answer. All right, so let's circle these. All right, next thing here. Is the statement, the monthly average of average cover of low clouds more directly correlated with the cosmic ray flux than is the monthly average of high clouds consistent with figures 1 and 3? And so basically it's saying, is the statement consistent with figures 1 and 3? All right, and so what does the statement say? You've got to summarize what the statement. So is this statement, what does the statement say? I'm going to give you about 20 seconds to paraphrase that statement. So paraphrase it now. All right, it says that yes. It says, well, I can answer the question, but what the statement says is the statement true with figures 1 and 3. All right, the monthly average of low percentage of low clouds. So the percentage of low cloud cover is low cloud cover related. Is the low cloud cover more correlated or related? Let's do related, more related than high cloud cover. With the cosmic reflux. Right, and we see that, yeah, if you look, remember, if we looked at, here's the high cloud, and here is the low cloud. Which one had more, looked more closely related? Definitely the low cloud. These questions are not as bad as you think. Right, you just have to comprehend what they say. And so you would say, yes. Be in, so it's either A or B. Yes, because the plot of the monthly average of cover of low clouds is more closely parallels the plot of the RCRF. That seems like the right answer, but let's look at the other one. Yes, because the plot of the monthly average cover of high clouds more closely parallels with the plot of the RCRF. No, not the R, it's the low clouds, not the high clouds. So this is going to be A. All right. And so the point is that these questions, they're not as bad as you think. You just need to have good reading comprehension. That's what the ACT more is about. It's more about reading comprehension than anything. All right. Now, the next question here. Which of the following best represents the monthly average of high, middle, and low clouds in January 1992? Okay. So it want, I'm paraphrasing it. It wants to know the average of cloud cover for in January 1992 for high, middle, and low clouds. So I look over here for high clouds. It is cloud covers the dash line. It's 13.5 about. So I'm gonna write 13. It's about 13.5, 92. Maybe a little bit, yeah. All right, for over here, for middle clouds, the cloud cover is 92, is about 20.25. And for the hot, low clouds in January 1992, all right, let me double check that. What do I make sure here? 92, yeah, 20.25. And 92, that is about 28. So which one had the highest? Low clouds, middle, and then high clouds. So it should be the highest in percentage for cloud cover was the low clouds. Yep. And it should be low clouds, middle clouds, and high clouds. So it's G. All right. So these are how to do these. I'm going to stop the video because I want you to have enough time to do your practice passage. I could do the last one, but one thought on the last one real quick is if I see a long question like that, I read the last sentence first, and then I read the whole thing, and then I answer my question. And sometimes, like in this last question, it's actually going to have to, you're going to have to refer back to the passage. Sometimes you have to refer to back to passage, but again, you don't have to read this whole passage because most of the information is going to be told right in the graphs and tables. So you're not going to have to do that over here. All right, I'm going to stop it. You're now going to pass out these things right here are, and you're going to pass out an answer document. You should get one of those, and you're going to pass out these here. All right. If it's F, you're going to write A. If it's G, it's you're going to write B. If it's H, you're going to write C. If it's J, it's D. All right. And so you're going to do the exact same thing. You're going to be on an 11-minute timer. All right. Miss Hartzell is going to set you on an 11-minute timer. And when the 11 minutes is up, you need to stop. ACT is time. And so these are both going to be charts and graphs passages. You're going to have 11 questions. All right, have fun. I'll see you on Monday. Bye.